I started painting kind of before a little bit, but I abandoned it off, like, because I had to concentrate on my tattooing. I started painting because I was in a, I hate to say it, and I hate to sound corny, but I was in a lot of pain mentally, and painting was the only thing besides the tattooing that I could do on my free time where I focused and I felt at ease. And along with music, I would put on music and paint. I just started painting like weird shit, like whatever came to my mind. I call it like the horror. I would paint weird faces. And and that, then I started, I was very fascinated with abandonment, abandoned buildings, desolation. So when I travel to Mexico, Puerto Rico, I take photos of graffiti, buildings, everything kind of sad, desolate. And maybe that reflected the way I felt back then. I'm still drawn to it. I don't feel that way anymore, but it's still, I still like looking at it, like desert, like, and an occasional palm trees, a little bit of litter and roots grown out of concrete. So that's what I do. I go on little trips and take tons of photos of stuff. And then I used to have a studio in Oakland, and then I would just paint and crank the paintings out like mad. Like I had a phase before I stopped, in my development, I stopped painting abandoned buildings, and I got totally into men. Men is another passion of mine. I love men in all kinds of forms, mostly beautiful men. So I would go around and pick out men I thought were beautiful and take photos of. I might take them on, I put them in a setting that was like, some of them were surface, I put them into like on the beach, or some of them downtown with really cool lighting, and I photographed them like for an hour and a half and direct them, and then I would paint them. I did like almost 10 of those, and I was gonna have a show with them, but then I gave them all away to those men. I gave them all their paintings because I felt that they have, like, all those men I've met during that time have helped me in developing myself in life. So it was sort of a thank you in a way. I don't know, the first times, like, when I did it, like, I think there must be something in the water and the ions, or like when you're in the water, even when I started like learning it, well, you're just in the white water and you try to kind of catch wave with your board, like you feel like, and you're not really paddling out all the way. Like what drew me to it is the way you feel afterwards. Like you feel like you exercised. You're out in nature, like, and the salt water does something. I don't know what it's like. It's almost like a drug. Like it makes you totally happy. You know, no matter what happened before you got in the water, it'll be gone by the time you get out of the water. And if you, like, and if you can, like, I tend to take that feeling when I had a good day, all the way throughout the day, the whole feeling of surfing. And as I progressed, like lately, like last week, I was paddling out there in like an ocean beach, and it's like, it's almost spiritual. You paddle and you're all alone, and the ocean is really big and powerful, and it's that part of overcoming your fear when you actually get a wave, when I start really getting a wave, like not just white water, and you stay on your boat and you ride the wave. It's almost better than sex. I did a few conventions. I did like a Puerto Rico convention. For me, conventions are only interesting if I like the town they're in. Or if they, like, for me, like, I like to travel and combine work, but frankly, I only like to travel. And if I travel, I don't like to work. So I did this for a little bit, and then I just realized, I don't know, I think it's cool to have conventions. I'm grateful that, like, there's TV shows about tattooing, because it brings awareness to customers. It eliminates a whole bunch of unnecessary questions. Not unnecessary, but sometimes I like educated customers. And though I don't mind stupid questions. But I have to say, I don't hang around with tattoo artists that much. Like, I have the guy who works for me, we go surfing together. And like, a lot of my friends don't actually have tattoos. My boyfriend doesn't have tattoos. It's what I do and I live for. I love tattooing. It's a part of me. But I don't like have to look like a tattoo artist. I don't have to like get the whole, like, I don't, this is a typical tattoo look, I call it. I don't know, I don't really I'm more than that. For I don't identify myself with more arts than that. Like, just being an artist, and tattooing is what I make my living with. Whether tattooing will peak, I think it's kind of like when I started in the 90s, it started going quite up. Like, and then it kind of was a plateaued for a while. And then all the TV show in the last like few years when they started having like Kat Von D and Miami Ink and all that out, it broadened the spectrum of customers more. It brought it even more in the mainstream than it was already there. I think it's gonna hold itself for a while where it is. I have to say, like, with the economy and all, tattooing has held up quite well. Because I think no matter what, when people don't have money, tattooing is so personal and it brings such a personal, selfish joy to one. Like the pain and sitting there and then having this on you that nobody can, you can never lose it. It's not like a painting that might burn down in a fire. So there's something really like about, I think the business will still grow. Slowly maybe, but I don't think it'll go down. Not for a while, because the people who just discovered it now. I tattooed like the other day, a woman was born in 1937. I think it was her first tattoo. It was awesome. I mean, like people like that come in, like men are a little bit weirder with like the old men are a little bit more like that. I don't know when we break into that spectrum. but especially the women have really contributed as customers a lot. And then as me as well as me with my career as I see myself in the future. Like I work a little bit too much right now. I like to work a little less, but more the things I want to do. I like to surf more and play more, and I can't see myself ever really retiring. I just love working, like, and tattooing, like doing fun tattoo. Yeah, I don't know. It's one day at a time. Like that's how I live my life, but I tried to. I had this vision of me being like a famous painter, but I'm like, I don't know. The painting thing is tattooing is much more successful than painting, in a way. Like it's kind of steady, and I do like what I would like to do for myself is not having to sit there all the 8 hours, and that's what I'm working towards. And having people making money for me while I'm making money, like at things I want to do. But yeah, no retirement for me. I'm gonna get a tattoo tomorrow.
You are?
Oh, no, after Wednesday I was doing the tattoo, huh?
From Paul?
Yeah.
And what are you getting this time?
Another rose on my back. I'm terrified of.
You're terrified of your rose or your back?
Of getting tattooed on my back.
Why?
Because it hurts. On the back.